Afghanistan is extremely important for India. We have high stakes in Afghanistan. We've invested more than $2 billion in the developmental assistance. We enjoy immense goodwill there. So we, India would certainly want to have very cordial relationship with Afghanistan. Now with this change scenario, the situation is obviously now going to be different. So far, India has not been engaged in the talks in any form because India maintains its position of not talking to the non-state actors. But if Taliban comes into power through the power sharing agreement, then obviously New Delhi will reevaluate its policy options and the new reality in Afghanistan. But India's role in Afghanistan, I think, definitely will be challenged with Pakistan's position now in Afghanistan with Taliban coming into power. If Taliban comes into power, obviously Pakistan will have a very, very strong role in Afghanistan, and that in turn will definitely impact India's engagement in Afghanistan.
As far as India is concerned, India has played a very important role so far in the various development and economic upliftment of Afghanistan. We almost given aid and assistance of the $3 billion worth, which is the largest as far as the regional countries are concerned. India has given huge political support to the Afghan government in Kabul. India has also given trained a large number of Afghan National Defense and Security Forces soldiers and officers in the country without having stepping inside Afghanistan per se. Now, as far as India is concerned, India has supported an Afghan-led and Afghan-owned peace process, and that is the way I think India will go in the future. The Afghan government is on board. If the Afghan government makes an agreement which is in tandem with their interests, India will support that agreement with the Taliban and the Afghan government. As very much little is known about the present agreement between the United States and Taliban, India has not made any open comments on that. But the way the Indian the approach is, I think they are depending on a strong Afghan-led and Afghan-owned peace process that is involving the Afghan government and which is constitutionally in tandem with the Afghan constitution at present.
Obviously, in a negative way, if the Taliban were left in a position to grab full power, but things are not so simple or easy for backers of the Taliban, and an uncertain, violent future still awaits Afghanistan, even after a peace accord and a phased withdrawal of US forces. The evolving situation there would leave many disgruntled players and power brokers hanging in a vacuum. So the Afghan scene will present opportunities for various regional powers, including India, Iran, Russia, to play a role either individually or in coordination with each other to preserve their own perceived national interests.